Hi, and welcome. We're here at Devoxx with Ludovic Champenois. Welcome, yep. Ludo. We're here to talk about cloud from Google, and specifically Google AppEngine and Google Compute Engine, which is the latest one. So, welcome, Ludo. You had a presentation here at Devoxx. You mentioned AppEngine,
yep.
And it's been around for a while. It's been kind of the pioneer in platform as a service clouds. What have you been up to? And by the way, you're the lead, the Java lead for
AppEngine. Taking care of the Java runtime for AppEngine. Yeah, I mean, AppEngine is a very long story. It started in 2008, and only last year it came out of preview. So so people could really use this service in a professional manner. So it was out of preview last year, November. And since then, we have done almost 12 releases, so one per month.
Wow.
So you can imagine every month, every single month, we keep adding services to it, and tuning the load balancer, or tuning the scalability of the service.
So you have new features regularly. So can you mention a few of those new features that
I mean, over the last year, we added, I think, Python 2.7, Go as a supported language. We re-architectured the data store from master slave to high replication data store.
So I think you added something scalable. Very interesting called data splitting or traffic splitting.
We have traffic splitting where you can split the traffic, based on IPs or cookies between different versions of the same application. So for example, you can try some of your traffic to newer version of your application.
Awesome. So one of the new things I hear is European data centers. So can you tell us what that
is?
Yes,
so it was, I think it was announced at Google I.O. in July, and it's starting ramping up. So for example, before it was only open to premier customer, and I think now we can open it to all the build customers. So it's basically AppEngine, but running in Europe in, of course, multiple data centers, but with a guarantee that your data and processing power will stay in Europe.
Okay.
So customers are billed in Euro, and it's much easier to be a customer when you are from Europe.
So as the Java lead, I need to ask you this question. Java 7 on AppEngine?
Interesting, yes. So we are, yes, of course, working on Java 7. In fact, the version of this month is in preview mode for a trusted tester. And we'll open it to everyone in December. So you can start testing your application with Java 7. Even if you do not use Java 7, the new features, not all of them are exposed yet in AppEngine, because we are still running the security audit around the Java 7 runtime. And you have seen recently some hacks trying to break the security of the JDK 7 itself that have been promptly fixed by Oracle. But security is a very important feature at Google, and we want to make sure that your application will run securely in Java 7.
Awesome. So looking forward to that before the end of the year, Java 7. So in terms of developer experience, nowadays people expect integration with Maven, with continuous integration, mm-hmm. and you know they have all those workflows. How well do we?
For Maven, the news of this month is we are working So first of all, we publish all the Maven artifacts for all the jars and libraries and SDK for AppEngine. And what we are adding this month is a new plugin where you can interact with AppEngine itself. So start the local SDK, update your application, update your backends, et cetera, et cetera. So all this from Maven POM rules.
Okay.
But we are also working with two partners. One of them is EXO to do development on the web, in the cloud. And I don't know if you have seen a demo of EXO IDE, but you can open a Maven project that you host on GitHub in the web and start editing it and deploying either to a local SDK running in the cloud or the real AppEngine runtime. So you don't need a laptop anymore, you need a Chromebook. I mean, with a Chromebook, you can effectively develop your AppEngine app.
Yeah, I've actually used Cloud IDE, yes, and it's very impressive. So, yeah.
So this is really for developers. Now for testing and building on a continuous manner, we have also done a partnership with CloudBees and their dev platform where you can run Jenkins builds, building your AppEngine app, and the as a post step for this build, you can deploy to AppEngine as well.
Okay, that's great. That I think helps developers with their tasks, daily tasks. They're all used to using Jenkins now.
Yeah, I mean, it's this
a
is
no-brainer.
Yeah, I mean, outside of internal Google, I mean, this is the de facto standard outside, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's switch gears a little bit. You talked about AppEngine, but you also talked about Compute Engine. So mm-hmm. tell us, this is infrastructure as a service running on Google's infrastructure.
Yeah, so, I mean, AppEngine is a big part of the cloud offering from Google, but we recently introduced Compute Engine, which is more, I mean, getting from the bottom, creating VMs and networks, connecting those VMs in a massive, scalable manner. Okay, the demo at Google I/O was using 600,000 cores to run, I mean, some computation on Google Cloud. So it's basically Linux kernel that you can create and boot on demand and install whatever software you want.
Okay, and so there's a notion of API that you use to manage all of this, because it's at a scale. If you have hundreds of thousands or even hundreds of...
So the way you manipulate this Compute Engine framework is via REST call, so it's a RESTful web services with JSON payload. And we have a command line tool and a nice web UI that allows you to create your payload, see it, so you can learn how to interact with Compute Engine very easily.
So if I post the proper JSON workload, I can actually create an instance and have it running?
Yeah, one or 10,000 of them.
Of course.
Depending on your credit card account.
And why would I do this? Do I get any benefit of running my virtual machines in Google's data center?
Because once you have a VM running inside the Google data center, then this VM has the most powerful network access to other Google services, whether it's cloud storage or MySQL or data store. So all the services will run in the same data center, so the communication will be optimal between those services.
Great, so lots of progress on AppEngine, Compute Engine,
yes,
coming soon. This is still in preview or in
So Compute Engine is still in preview and selected trusted tester. We are looking for massive computation partners before opening it more to more developers.
Okay, great. Well, I guess that's all the time we have for it. Thank you, Ludo, for
thank you for having
spending
me.
The time and answering those questions.
Bye.
Cheers.